Alright, welcome to Side Games. We're playing Dyad. It is me, Andrew, versus Will. And we are going to,
It's Andrew versus gas.
Sorry. Damn. It was that ice cream I had earlier.
So Andrew versus Will versus ass versus motion controls versus colorful stuff.
Let's go ahead and do danger.
Danger.
Because that actually has enemies and an opportunity to lose.
Andrew's the only person who understands this game.
Yes.
So, good for him.
So there you go. There's the instructions if you need them. So the idea is to get as many points as possible before racing to the end. Hook pairs of the same colored enemies to score a point. Avoid running into enemies.
You try to like link enemies together?
Yes. All right, and
man.
Go.
Without running into
PlayStation Plus, what have you done to UNFAIRnament?
What on earth are you?
Are you pressing a button to link them?
X.
X?
I don't even.
Okay, so you go up to enemies and like link them into each other. Okay.
Yeah. Color.
So it looks like he's targeting two enemies that are the same color, but linking them with X, but also dodging them, so he doesn't actually touch them.
Yeah.
Can you just mash X to hit them, or do you have to target them?
No. You have to target.
Yeah. It looks like you target them with the weird thing that's out in front of you to link them together, but you don't want to touch them with your actual character, because that'll hurt you, I guess.
So you've got what, one joystick that moves your character and one that moves your target?
Yeah. No.
No. Your target, you're targeting in front of you all the time.
You just have to line yourself.
It's literally just movement and X.
You're just rotating yourself and hitting X.
Okay.
Yay, another game.
This game's beautiful. I'm gonna fucking throw up now.
Yeah.
I've never been so close to having motion sickness in a video game before.
Really?
This is really something.
I mean, I'm pretty susceptible.
We're gonna have to play Space Giraffe next season.
Or let's not.
Let's get a piece of the fuck out of everybody.
You're supposed to keep like a pretty consistent flow going.
See, so once you link them,
we'll play on the level called No Yipping.
Yeah.
Enemy pairs close.
So there we go.
So when did it end? Was that the first of three levels or something?
Yeah.
How does the scoring happen?
You'll see it at the end of it all.
Okay.
So you don't even know if you're winning?
No.
Oh, wow. Okay, so we're just doing one run.
So there's some sort of crazy numerical score it'll show us later, I guess?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's either that or it shows you how many
you linked.
This game's
really pretty.
Yeah,
I'm glad I get to play it for free.
Yeah, PlayStation Plus is great.
Yeah. They just threw, because I wasn't sure if I wanted this game because I couldn't tell what it was, but now I just get to try it regardless.
Yeah.
Fuck! What the hell's happening?
You're playing poorly?
Yeah, I don't know why I'm running into shit, though. Do you have
Probably because it's really hard to tell what's going on the screen. This isn't how life looks at all. This would be a huge upset if Will somehow pulled it through.
That would be amazing.
Yeah, why? Also disappointing because I want you guys to play Union on Jack.
Which I'll probably lose.
So. I want Will to win. Every single UNFAIRnament, my goal is to win. And once I realize I'm not winning, my goal is that the person who hasn't won yet wins.
That's nice of you.
Yep. Except Chris, she'll never win.
Oh,
I was just waiting for that.
She'll have to become good at video games first. Hey, she has a better chance than Arya.
Is that true?
Maybe.
Isn't she like a savant that like
Chris is
that Kirby game or whatever?
Arya and Chris are like, Arya seems to be both bad at most games, but Chris is like freakishly good at really random games and then almost nothing else. It's like Smash Brothers, she's scary. It's like if someone faced Smash Brothers and Chris are in Smash Brothers in this tournament and they're not like, maybe me, then they're in trouble. I often beat her, but that's phrasing.
That's phrasing. I'm being generous to myself because no one else is here.
At Jake's house, we had a Smash Brothers tournament, and Carissa took me out in the first round.
Holy
and
shit.
Then went on to lose in the last round of the entire tournament. Versus Jake's savant little crazy 5-year-old brother or whatever.
God damn it.
Yay! Let's keep distracting him with Smash Brothers conversation so he continues to be bad at games.
So what does the -3 do to you?
It lowers my score. Fuck!
Oh, it's just your score. It's not like a life, you can't die.
Does it affect
your... Well, you can die, but that's only if you like really fucking suck at this.
Wait, so is it affecting your final score, or is it subtracting from your enemy pair's hook?
It's subtracting from my enemy pair's.
Okay.
Which is how you get score.
Because I think when you get to the end of a sector, you have to have that many hook to pass, basically.
Pretty much.
And you get more points by kicking that standard's ass, basically.
What happens if you get to the end of the sector and you haven't hooked that many?
I don't know, maybe it just ends.
So,
you have to get 54 hooks.
You need to be 54.
Yeah, you need to be 54.
Oh, shit, -3.
54.
So,
retry. Okay, yeah, so X is how you hook them, and you just move with the left joystick.
Okay.
All right, I believe in you, Will. No, no.
Yeah.
That's 54 hooks. I believe in you.
Wow, that was Andrew's high score.
Yeah.
His previous time playing, he got 33. So, no pressure. He's just playing at the top of his game ever.
There's also a time limit.
That's extra shitty. Is when you realize the person who already knows how to play the game just played their best game.
Right?
Jesus Christ. This game's really nice looking. I like it.
It is nice looking, but it's fucking chaotic.
Yeah, and it hurts my brain. I feel like this is a game where if I look away from it, things are going to look like they're still scrolling, like sliders or something.
Yeah, it's certainly...
This is basically sliders, the video game.
It's like when you try watching a Rock Band when you're not playing.
Oh, yeah.
And it's just like everything just starts scrolling up. Even when you look away, you're like, what is happening?
I'm gonna feel like an asshole if this isn't the Space Giraffe guy, but it feels like it, because that guy basically, his whole career is like, seems to be just him remaking the game Tempest over and over again.
Yeah.
Which is like Tempest to Space Giraffe to, I think, Dyad. It's just the same game over and over again.
Yeah.
Of going in a circle and interacting with the things that are coming at you.
Which, I mean, if you got a niche and you just play it out as much as you possibly can.
A niche for very few people to buy games in.
So much.
Oh my god, he's just mashing the X button and staying still at that point. Oh, no. Okay.
Yeah, there you go. Just one more hook.
Or you're fucked. You better hook up the fucking... No, yep. Yeah.
There you go.
Will's gonna make it past the first level unless he crashes. So the 22 is what you need in order to get your third star.
Yes.
Oh, so he goes through all three sectors regardless of how many he has up then.
Okay.
I was misjudging
it. His rank is just based on... But if you get... No, there is a par you need to make.
Yeah. But okay, so it is the number you're seeing there is actually just the star rating system.
Yeah.
Well, I wonder why three stars became so popular. I guess his mobile phones started doing them a lot with like Angry Birds.
Yeah.
I think it's because 5 stars because I played Rock Band. Damn. My fanboyism is correct and other people's are wrong.
No, because 3 stars makes more sense. You're either shitty, okay, or amazing.
No, I like other ones better.
Why? 5 stars
doesn't
make any
sense. 1 star, 2 star, 3 star, 4 star, 5 star, gold star.
How do you even
make this as complicated as possible?
Yeah, like it was stupid as fuck. And your score, like,
I just have an aversion to 3 stars because I'm used to mobile games just giving me 2 out of 3 with no explanation. No, I don't understand what I'm doing wrong.
Well, that's Angry Birds.
Yeah.
Angry Birds is like, I expect you to be a semi-god. And you're like, I don't even know what that means, Angry Birds.
I'm like, do you know that you're a touchscreen game?
Yeah, like, do you know you're just a remake of Catapult? Like, what the fuck do you want from me?
Dude, I played that game before Angry Birds, too. Like,
the Angry Birds guys played it before Angry Birds.
Will's fucking up.
Shit.
This is the part where Will loses.
Like, that's the irony, is that they just
enjoy your failure. You just lost your 3rd star, I think.
Yeah.
Oh.
Are you kidding me? I shot that. Were there 2 of them?
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Do they even go away when you shoot them? I thought you were just hooking them, so they're still
no,
there.
No, you just hook them. They stay there.
Yeah.
It looks like it pushes them back a little
no,
bit.
No,
yeah, but
you forward.
But if you don't move, you're going to crash into them.
Yeah, it pushes you forward.
Yeah.
So you can run into them.
No one said anything about shooting. You're just hooking 2 enemies together. Like
context.
Audio. It's like audio surf. Except not.
Yeah, except not.
Except nothing like audio
except,
surf.
Except the things you run. I think in audio surf you have to run into stuff to gain points. This one you don't.
This game's so colorful.
Well, it's not that colorful. It's
I don't
fucking...
think I'm gonna manage to put a woman with big breasts on the cover of this thumbnail.
Yes, you can.
I can find a way. I can just
find a girl in a tie-dye shirt.
Just draw a naked woman with like. Ooh. Just draw a woman in a bikini with like. Just completely drawn out of like orange and cyan, like bursts of light, like constellation.
Just capture a screenshot from fucking Star
Trek.
She's like a
Playboy constellation.
Jesus.
Oh, the things that happened in my head.
Playboy constellation.
That's the name of a fucking podcast.
I don't even know. I can't even think of how. That would be the Playboy podcast. This is the Playboy constellation.
I was just thinking, like, when you do a podcast, like, you usually name that episode after some phrase that happened in that episode.
Yeah. Okay.
If you once someone says Playboy constellation, that's just what you name that episode. Aw.
Man.
Will is banking hard.
So.
Is he all the way down to 8 out of 20? Wow.
The speed changes just jack up my time.
Yeah.
That's why I like this game, because...
Right. We're about to find out if you get a negative score on this game or not.
Because if you can't keep up, you will lose, which is why I chose this game in the first place, because it's like,
so
I'm really
cool.
Good at these stupid fucking, like, bright color, moving fast games.
This is gonna be pretty when I'm editing.
Yeah.
Yeah, pretty fucking
So I think we'll lost.
Oh, I'm sure.
Fair way to just wager.
12.
Oh, oh no.
God, all those running into things.
Enjoy your one star, Will. Well, next time on UNFAIRnament, Will, right. Will and Lewis are tied. You gotta do a tiebreaker, hook up that 360, we're doing You Don't Know Jack.
Today's wrong answer of the game is brought to you by Bob's Knob Shop. The prices will have you slobbering over Bob's Knobs.